Welcome back to Fluid Mechanics Lecture Series. I am your SumamMiss. My channel name is also SumamMiss. You can watch my videos on my channel. If you found useful, please don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe. Estimation of energy loss encountered by the fluid during its travel is an important step for a hydraulic engineer during the design and safe operation of piping system. So, the knowledge of computation of energy loss is very much essential for preparing this total energy line and hydraulic gradient line. So, total energy line is the graphical representation of total energy along the length of the pipe. So, total energy that is equal to P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus Z. And hydraulic gradient line is the graphical representation of the piezometric head along the length of the pipe. Piezometric head equal to P by rho g plus Z. Or the difference between total energy line and hydraulic gradient line is velocity head. Now let us see how we can draw the total energy line. So in this figure you can see that a pipe is drawing water from the tank. If there is no loss is accounted, the total energy line is coinciding with this red dotted line. But here you can see that the flow is entering to a smaller pipe and it is exiting outward. So the flow through this pipe is getting affected by the entrance loss and friction loss. So we can calculate entrance loss and marked here so that the total energy is dropped from this level of this tank to this point. Then it is dropping downward because energy here is consumed by the friction losses. So that is why total energy line is dropping downward here. So this amount that indicates the friction loss, whereas from this portion to this portion, which indicates the entrance loss. So same approach we can also adapt it for the computation of hydraulic gradient line. So before computing the hydraulic gradient line, we must draw the total energy line. So here you can see that the tank discharging water through a pipe. So this is the total energy line. So the total loss include the entrance loss plus friction loss. So the one which is marked in red line, which indicates the total energy line. In the system, if you are inserting a piezometer and a pitot tube, you can see that the liquid level in the pitot tube is higher than the liquid level in the piezometer, because piezometer is used to represent the piezometric head, whereas pitot tube indicates the total energy. The difference between this pitot tube level and this piezometer, which indicates the pitot velocity head. So this can be explained by applying Bernoulli's equation at the section 1 and the section 2. At this free surface, the pressure is atmosphere pressure and velocity equal to 0. So the point 1 is located at a distance z1 from the datum. So Bernoulli's equation at the section 1 equal to P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus z1, that is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2 plus HL. Or the total energy available at the section 1, that is Z1, that is equal to total energy available at the section 2 plus head loss. Head loss includes HE plus HF. So in order to draw the hydraulic gradient line, initially we have to draw the total energy line, then put a vertical drop from the total energy line by an amount of velocity head, that will give you the hydraulic gradient line. So this can be explained more detail by considering a pipe segment of different area of cross section. So here you can see that, so AB is the pipe segment of converging section. It is connected to a diverging portion BC. Then it is connected to a uniform pipe CD. At the point B, where the velocity is maximum and then it is decreasing to the point C, then it becomes uniform. So here you can see the total energy line represented by TEL. So at this point, velocity head equal to V1 square by 2G. Whereas here you can see that cross-sectional area is minimum. That means velocity is maximum. So this hydraulic gradient line here is dropping down because of this maximum velocity head. So here you can see that area is increasing. That means velocity is getting decreased. You can see that velocity head is decreased from this point to this point. So initially the velocity head was from this point to this point. Now the velocity head is from this point to this point. Then from the point C, you can see that velocity is not changing because of the constant cross-sectional area. So before drawing hydraulic gradient line, you have to draw total energy line. Then from that total energy line, you have to drop the vertical corresponding to the velocity head. In that way, you can draw the hydraulic gradient line. So the change in piezometric head per unit length of the pipe is known as hydraulic gradient, whereas the change in total energy head per unit length of the pipe is known as energy gradient. So this can be explained in more detail by solving a problem. So in this section, we can discuss the method of sketching total energy line and hydraulic gradient line by solving this problem. So the figure shows a tank which is connected by two pipes in series. The height of water that is available above the center line that is given, that is equal to 10 meter, and the diameter of these two pipes are given. The diameter of the first pipe that is equal to 200 mm and corresponding length is also available, that is equal to 30 meter. Similarly, the diameter of the second pipe that is given as 100 mm and the corresponding length is given as 10 meter. It is freely discharging to atmosphere. Then the coefficient of friction that is given as 0.008. So the first step is we can write down all the data and we can convert that into proper unit. So the losses taking place in this problem is entrance loss, then frictional loss, again the loss due to contraction, and the friction loss. So since this liquid is going out, the complete energy that is getting exhausted, or algebraic sum of all these losses including the exit loss, that is equal to 10 meter. So continuity equation is varied here. So A1 V1 that is equal to A2 V2. So from that we can establish a relationship between V1 and V2 because A1 and A2 are available. So we can write V1 equal to 0.25 V2. So the expression for entrance loss, that is equal to 0.5 into V1 square by 2G. So V1 that is equal to 0.25 V2. So entrance loss is calculated as 0.00159 V2 square. Next step is the calculation of the frictional loss for the pipe section 1. Since coefficient of friction is given, then the loss equation for this pipe section 1, that is equal to 4 into F into L1 V1 square by 2G D1. So D1 is available and V1 that is equal to 0.25 V2. So if you are substituting, then HF1 can be expressed in terms of V2 as 0.01529 V2 square. Next is the contraction loss taking place at the section D. So the equation is 0.5 V2 square by 2G. So contraction loss HC equal to 0.0255 V2 square. Next part is calculation of friction loss for the pipe segment 2. That is equal to 4FL2 V2 square by 2GD2. So that is obtained as 0.1631 V2 square. Then exit loss that is equal to V2 square by 2G. That is equal to 0.05096 V2 square. So all these losses together, that is entrance loss, frictional loss, contraction loss, again the friction loss, plus exit loss equal to 0.25644 V2 square. So that is equal to 10 meter. So this total head that is available is completely exhausted by the losses, that is equal to 0.25644 V2 square, that is equal to 10 meter. So we can calculate V2 based on this concept, or we can apply the Bernoulli's equation at this point A and at the point E. At the point A, it is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus 10, that is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2 plus head loss up to this point. So it is 0 because at the point A, pressure, that is atmosphere pressure, and velocity head, that is equal to 0, plus Z equal to 10, that is equal to, here at this outlet, pressure is 0 plus V2 square by 2G plus Z equal to 0 plus loss up to this point E. So V2 obtained a 6.245 meter per second, and V1 is 0.25 V2. So you will get V1 as 1.56 meter per second. Since current indication is valid, A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. So discharge is calculated as 0.049 meter cube per second. So the total loss we have to account for drawing the total energy line is entrance loss, friction loss, loss due to contraction, and the friction loss. Now let us discuss how we can draw this total energy line and hydraulic gradient line. So this is our system. So if there is no loss in the system, total energy line is in line with this point A. Because of this entrance losses, this total energy line is dropping down to this point. So by an amount, H entrance equal to 0.062 meter. So at this point B, the total energy equal to EA minus 0.062 meter. Now, because of the friction loss, energy available here is getting consumed by the friction losses. So this line is further dropping downward because of this friction loss taking place for the pipe segment 1 by an amount that is equal to HF1, that is equal to 0.5963 meter. So that means total energy available at the point C, that is equal to energy level at this B minus HF1. Now, area of cross-section is reduced at this point. So at the point D, total energy is dropped by an amount that is correspond to head loss due to sudden contraction, that is equal to 0.9945 meter. So at the point D, the total energy equal to the total energy available at this level minus 0.9945 meter. Now we have to sketch the total energy available at the section E. So because of the friction losses, the total energy line is dropping down by an amount that is equal to HF2, that is equal to 6.3599 meter. So this is the total energy available at the section E. So this can be written as EA equal to 10 meter, EB that is equal to EA minus H entrance, that is equal to 9.938 meter, then EC that is equal to EB minus this friction loss equal to 9.3417 meter, then ED that is equal to the energy level at this point minus the contraction losses, that is 8.3472 meter, then energy level at the E equal to ED minus HF2, so that is equal to 1.987 meter. So the total energy available at the section E, that is equal to 1.987 meter. So this line, that is the combination of this red color and green line, that is starting from this point, it is dropping down, then it is dropping vertically down, and it again, it is dropping like this. That is the total energy line. So total energy line equal to P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus Z. Whereas hydraulic gradient line, that is joining of the piezometric level, equal to P by rho g plus Z. So the difference between total energy line and piezometric head, that is equal to V square by 2g. So we can drop a vertical V1 square by 2g for this pipe section 1 and V2 square by 2g for this pipe section 2. So for drawing hydraulic gradient line, then we have to calculate the piezometric head at the point B as HB as EB minus V1 square by 2g. Then hydraulic gradient line at C, that is equal to EC, that is this point, minus V1 square by 2g. So this is the hydraulic gradient for this point C. Then for the point D, ED minus V2 square by 2g. So that is this level. Then for this point E, then we have to deduct V2 square by 2g from this level. So that means this line now touches this water level here. So this line that is drawn here, which represents the hydraulic gradient line. So the estimation of energy loss encountered by this fluid during its travel is very much essential to draw this total energy line and hydraulic gradient line. So the knowledge of drawing this total energy line and hydraulic gradient line is one of the essential steps for a design engineer for the safe design and operation of any hydraulic piping system. In the next section, we can discuss about the behavior of the pipes in series and how an equivalent pipe can be utilized to replace the pipes in series. So here you can see that pipes which are connected in series, and L1, L2, L3 are the length of these pipes, and D1, D2, D3 are the diameter. So conductification is varied here, that is Q1 equal to Q2 equal to Q3, that is equal to Q. So total head loss, that is equal to HF1 plus HF2 plus HF3. So if this compound pipe is replaced by a single pipe of uniform diameter such that the total loss of head due to friction, then total length and total discharge are same, then it is called equivalent pipe. So the equation employed for the calculation of diameter of this equivalent pipe, that is called the Pude's equation. So total loss in the system equal to HL equal to HF1 plus HF2 plus HF3. So we can utilize these two relationships so that the diameter of this equivalent pipe can be determined. This is the compound pipes and this is the equivalent pipe. So the length of the equivalent pipe equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3, and discharge through this equivalent pipe, that is a same as Q. Now total head loss is equivalent pipe, that is equal to HF1 plus HF2 plus HF3. So this can be expanded as FL V square by 2GD, which indicates the head loss along this equivalent pipe equal to head loss for the pipe segment 1 plus head loss for the pipe segment 2 plus head loss for the pipe segment 3. So here we neglect the minor losses, only frictional losses are accounted. Now from the continuity equation, we can replace velocity in terms of Q by area, because Q is same throughout. So V equal to Q by A, or V square equal to Q square by A square. So corresponding changes we can make in this equation so that it can be written as FL Q square divided by 2G d raised to 5, because pi by 4 is common, that is cancelled throughout. If the material of the pipe is common, that is F is same throughout. So we can eliminate the terms F, Q and 2G from this equation. Then this equation can be written as L divided by D raised to 5 equal to L1 by D1 raised to 5 plus L2 divided by D2 raised to 5 plus L3 divided by D3 raised to 5. So in this equation, all the terms in RHS is known, and L, that is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3, then we can write D equal to L divided by L1 divided by D1 raised to 5 plus L2 divided by D2 raised to 5 plus L3 divided by D3 raised to 5 raised to 1 by 5. So this is a Pude equation for finding the diameter of this equivalent pipe. Similarly, we can connect the pipes in parallel to increase the discharge. Here you can see that two pipes connected in parallel connecting two tanks. So the difference in liquid level in these two tanks, that is equal to H. So that means head loss for the pipe section 1, that is equal to head loss for the pipe section 2, that is equal to H. So that means FL1 V1 square by 2GD1 equal to FL2 V2 square by 2GD2. So if you are using same material pipe and if the diameter is known, then we can establish a relationship between V1 and V2. And the total discharge Q, that is equal to Q1 plus Q2, or it can be written as A1 V1 plus A2 V2. Since a relationship between V1 and V2 are available, you can express Q in terms of V2 or in terms of V1. So we can find out V1, then you can find out Q1, or we can find out V2, then we can find out Q2. So in that way, we can find out the variables. So it's now the session comes to end. For the time being, it is enough. Thank you. My next video